What the fuck is this? Oh, it better not be what I think it is! Bastards. What is this? Who the fuck are you? Slimy little fucks! What the hell did they come here and put all these things? Little piece of crap.
You think you can get me that easily, huh? Nice try, you fucks! What the fuck do you want, huh? I'm right here!
Those little fucks. You think you can find with me?
Don't you fucking move, I swear to God! Stop right there!
What? What?
Dr. Smith? Dr. Smith?
Yes, sorry, I'm with you.
I have the information you requested concerning the patient that came in tonight. He claims that someone broke into his house and tried to strangle him, and that he used his firearm in an attempt to defend himself. What's weird is that there's nothing in the police report that indicates any break-in. There are some minor bruises on his body, but they all seem self-inflicted. The police also interrogated the neighbor who called the police. She claims to have seen him tossing books from his bookshelves frantically, seemingly searching for something.
And what was he searching for?
It's hard to tell. He refuses to answer most of our questions, claiming we already know the answers. He believes we're partly responsible for what happened. It's not really surprising. I took a look at his medical background, and he's had really bad cases of...
scopophobia.
Exactly.
Thanks, Tim. I'll go and see him right away.
Of course. He'll be in the transit wing, room 323 until further notice. He seems agitated, so be careful.
Thanks, Tim. Duly noted.
Call to employees. Code white in room 323. Code white in room 323. Call to security. Code white. Emergency in room 323. Code white. Emergency in room 323.
Don't you dare touch me, you fuck!
I'm not giving us much of a choice here, sir.
Seize him and give him the sedative.
Now! Get off me! Fuck off!
Follow-up of patient number 9 on request from Smith Walter. Patient name, Raken Almutawa. Gender, male, age 28. After Raken's first evaluation, it is safe to say that he'll be staying here for a while. I was able to get him to talk about his paranoia. The patient believes that the whole scenario has been organized by some evil corporation in order to brainwash him into subjugation. He believes his mental capacity and awareness prevented them from getting to him. Adding to the severity of his case, he is sometimes afflicted with hallucinations. He has described these hallucinations to me as an eyeless humanoid that keeps on watching him wherever he is. Due to his psychotic behavior and his difficulty differentiating reality from paranoiac fabrication, he has been transferred to the psychiatric wing. He also displays violent behavior towards the staff, is considered to be dangerous, should be sedated and under constant surveillance in the psychiatric ward.